Another group believes the government should just tax the rich to increase its revenues instead of taking on more loans. The Freedom from Debt Coalition warns incurring more debt may lead to a repeat of what happened during the time of the president's father, the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos Sr.
Dapat tingnan ng mga technocrats, ang ating pong ekonomiya ngayon nakaupo sa isang, in English, slippery slope. Noong panahon ni Marcos Sr., Ferdinand Marcos Sr., noong dekada 70, martial law, utang tayo ng utang, at sabi ni ng mga technocrat noong 1978-79, don't worry, just borrowing, because the economy would grow. Pero ano po nangyari? Sumabog yung krisis sa ekonomiya, 1980-81, sumabog yung krisis sa utang, at tapos nagkaroon tayo ng recession, again depression, at natuloy na sa EDSA 1.
The Philippine Health Department looking to put up more primary care facilities across the country. That's as government data shows many Filipinos die without ever having the chance to seek professional help. The details from Rafael Bosano.
When Lelan Reyes first felt pain on her upper breast, she immediately went to the hospital for consultation. But she never returned since then, saying they can't afford a regular checkup. Now a mass has formed on her breast, causing her severe pain.
Tinitiis ko na lang po yung sakit. Yun, tumatawag ako sa Panginoon, sana alisin niya yung sakit. Pag sumasakit, umiyak po ako, iniinda ko yung sakit. Tapos lalo na yung asawa ko, nakikita niya, umiyak rin siya.
She's not alone. There are more like her who are unable to get a medical checkup or much needed treatment. This is why primary healthcare facilities like the one in Lubao, Pampanga is a lifeline for indigent patients. The Philippine Health Department says these facilities will help ease the burden of hospitals and provide free services to the public.
Pine-prevent natin na magkasakit further at magkakomplikasyon pa ang mga tao by having this first contact point ng bawat tao dito sa ating healthcare system. Ito po ang makakasolve sa napakataas na burden natin ngayon sa ating mga ospital. If only we will have this kind of primary care services to our people, yun pong mga kailangan pumunta ng ospital, unti-unti po yan mababawasan.
Services include screening for different ailments like tuberculosis, gastroenteritis, dermatological diseases as well as hypertension, diabetes, and chronic respiratory diseases. Based on data from the Philippine Statistics Authority, 52% or more than 322,000 deaths in 2019 occurred inside the home. 41.2% of deaths happened without being attended to by doctors or other allied healthcare providers.
Di na sila pumupunta sa ospital kasi hindi ho siguro accessible. Eh, wala ho sigurong pera para pumunta sa ospital at magpagamot. Kaya marami sa ating mga kababayan, namamatay na lang po sila sa kanilang bahay without any kind of medical attention. And that is very critical.
So far, there are over 200 licensed primary care facilities in different regions, including Cagayan Valley, Bicol Region, Cordillera Administrative Region, Central Luzon, Calabar Zone, and Mimaropa. The DOH hopes to replicate this in other areas to give people like Lenlen a chance to seek medical help, which is a basic human right, without spending a single centavo. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.
President Marcos appoints new election commissioners. Constitutional and law professor Ernesto Maceda Jr. has been appointed to the COMELEC and Bank. He will now serve until February 2029. Maceda said he is humbled to be entrusted with the crucial duties and responsibilities of the office of the commissioner. Meanwhile, COMELEC also confirmed the reappointment of Commissioner Nelson Celis, who was recently bypassed by the Commission on Appointments due to a lack of time. The poll body said Celis's expertise in information technology will immensely benefit the automated electoral processes. The new appointments complete the 7-member COMELEC on bank.